the firms are all male. A minority of the firms have one female partner. And so, and when you look at how much money, I think the NVCA says that the venture industry manages $330 billion. The majority of that money is managed by, and the firms are managed by men, and the majority of the money is invested into companies founded by men.
I've definitely had experiences where I do not feel like I was welcome to the same parties or given the same access. There's times I felt like I was second-guessed or marginalized or made to feel like an imposter. And I always feel like I had to be that much more aggressive, that much better, that much more forthcoming, and deliver returns at a higher level than my male peers just to be given a seat at the table.
Watching friends and peers in the industry opt out and opt to go back to operating roles instead of sticking with growing in venture because there were more choices and there were better choices on the other side, I mean, that really stings. You really realize that there's a reason why there are few and few people at the top, or few and fewer women at the top, because there just isn't necessarily the pathways for women that there have been for men.
Are you fighting an uphill battle when you try to kind of change the tides? Yes, but I think the winds are starting to move in our favor. I think the awareness is growing, and I think that there are some really well-intentioned people around us who want the change to happen and need some help in making it.
Most of the industry has good intention and are good, but there's enough bad that's seeping into kind of every corner that it became clear that we had to do something more.
Starting with Susan Fowler's blog post, we started to see the steady drumbeat of not only just a request for change, but a demand for change. And it was on multiple fronts. It was around sexual harassment, but it was the equal treatment of women and the recognition that women were really bringing value into the industry.
I think this group can be a part of what's already happening, which is this sort of this change that is occurring, that the industry can no longer sort of miss the point that it needs to change, that we need to diversify. And I think this group is in a position to really move the needle forward in having more women partners, into mentoring women who are more junior to come up in venture capital, as well as getting more female founders to receive funding. So I think we can have an impact at almost every part in the tech industry.
There's a lot of change happening. Some of that change, I think, is being motivated by fear, like fear of, you know, repercussions or being outed. I think there needs to be a shift. And I think what we're focused on is, instead of motivating people through fear, motivating them through greed. Because I think we know that women are capable of running massively successful companies as founders, and women are capable of driving massive returns as funders. So I think if we can accelerate that success and make it in everyone's best interest to back more female founders and funders, that's a big part of the role that we can play in the movement.